All right, we're at the second intermission here at the TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac out in front of Yale, 3-2 in quite the battle. Now, everybody knows about the academic reputation that Yale University has, but Quinnipiac looking to try and step up their reputation as well. They had an announcement about a month or so ago that Quinnipiac will be opening a medical school in the near future. And Billy Mack is standing by with the president of Quinnipiac University, John Lahey, and they'll chat about that. Billy?
John, thanks for joining us. Now, switch gears a little bit to the academic component. Big news end of January, medical school for Quinnipiac University.
Absolutely. I think in many ways it's a very logical step. It's, of course, a big step, but we have a nationally recognized school of health sciences. We already train physician assistants, nurse practitioners. So this medical school is going to be a little different from some of the others. We're going to put a big emphasis on primary care, family physicians, and so I think it's going to be a great addition to the mix of programs that we have here, our school of health sciences, our law school, our business school, communication school, school of arts, college of arts and sciences, and school of medicine. We'll have what all the great universities have now in terms of our programming.
Now, in order to do this, you had to have a campus, and that North Haven campus that you opened in August is what a place.
It's starting to get full. It was 570,000 square feet of space, sounded like an awful lot a couple of years ago, but we've used 130,000 of it for the School of Health Sciences. We'll use about 150 or 60,000 for School of Medicine, and then eventually we'll move our law school there as well. So it's a beautiful graduate campus, and when you think of it, again, having a medical school, a School of Health Sciences, we're going to move our nursing program to a School of Nursing, and our School of Law and our School of Education, all graduate programs. It'll be a tremendous facility and outstanding place for our students and our faculty.
Interesting stat I think I saw, and I think I've heard you mention, it is only really a handful of schools that universities that have both law school and a medical school. What's that number?
Absolutely. Well, there are 3,600 colleges and universities in America, only 200 ABA-approved law schools, and only 135 LCME-accredited medical school, and only 89 universities in the country have both a medical school and a law school. So Quinnipiac will be the 90th, we hope by September 2013.
Well, that's great news here from Quinnipiac on the academic front, and pretty good hockey game tonight, huh?
Oh, terrific. And the crowd. I mean, it's a huge crowd. I've met with our students down there. I told them from where I sit, it's a sea of yellow that I see down there. But a great game. Yale's been tremendous for us, supported our entrance into the ECAC. And this game, I think in time, you know, the people in New Haven are going to start not referring to the Harvard-Yale football game as the game, but the Quinnipiac-Yale hockey game as the game.
Well, thanks for joining us, John. Back upstairs, fellas.
All right, I know the game has a little bit of history to it, John. Quinnipiac with a 3-2 lead. We're heading to the third period.